The first question is because I've been writing a lot of posts regarding yoga and the different mind sorts, etc. So I'll begin with the most basic question, which might be there on everybody's mind. How would you define yoga, and who is a yogi?
Okay, so I think yoga is the science of becoming worthy to achieve your desires. The word yoga itself means to be worthy. Okay, worthiness. The true meaning of yoga is worthiness. It also carries another meaning, which is union. Okay, to unite with. All right, but unite what? To unite your skills along with your outcomes. So many people go around looking for outcomes which are better, but without making their skills better. That is ayog. It is not yog. Okay. But what is yoga? It is uniting your skill level to the outcome that you want. If this is the outcome you want, then your skill level has to be the same level. But otherwise, you know, you are not doing yoga. So any yogi with this is skill level and this is outcome, not yoga. But it has to be more or less, more or equal. Yeah.
Okay. So we could say that it is becoming capable of what we desire, or what.
Yeah. In other words, yes, you could definitely say that. Yeah, that's a great way to put it. Becoming capable of what we desire is called yoga. Okay. So many people mistake this to be a spiritual science. Like, you know, it is also. This is the most spiritual thing you can do. But it is not divorced from the material world like many people think. So I know some people who say, I've been practicing yoga for so long, but when it comes to charging people, I really have a problem. And he's not a yogi. He's an ayogi, because he doesn't have the skills to ask for money to sustain himself. Why can't you? Okay. So a lot of people told me, I'm very uncomfortable with the fact that I have to pay you. Why can't you have like a donation box, and then I'll put whatever I want. I'm like, anyway, you're paying me. Just pay what I want instead of what you want. Right? So people have a lot of issues marrying spirituality with materialism. But hello, where does your spirit reside? In your physical body. So yoga is a very practical path for anybody in the world. You don't have to wear yellow clothes like me. You can still be a yogi. Even if you wear regular office clothes and go to a job, you can still be a yogi, right? Yeah, so that's about that.
Okay.
Was there more to the question? I'm sorry, I missed it. Was there more to the question?
No, that was all basically. What is yoga and who is a yogi?
Who's a yogi? Yeah, that's great. Anybody can be a yogi as long as they're matching their skills to their expectations.